The infamous Emperor Nero played an instrument very similar to the one she's playing, the lyre. Legend has it that he played it merrily as he watched.
As he watched?
As he watched Rome burn.
I'm playing a trans person in Mr. Robot. And so as a result, I've taken, ostensibly taken an opportunity for a trans actor away from a trans actor. And that is something that is an issue because of the lack of visibility for trans actors. I, as an Asian American actor, also feel a lack of visibility as an Asian American person. And so it was a chip that I kind of cashed in that I'm not so crazy about having had done it. But it does speak to a situation that, I mean, that's really why I'm telling you about it, is because it speaks to a situation which is that there is a lack of visibility. There is, for all of our talk of inclusivity and equality and all of that, there's still a kind of a line that doesn't get crossed yet where we're really fluid with diversity and inclusion, and we're working towards that. And shows like Mr. Robot, which are extremely diverse shows, and other shows like it, are trying to push that envelope. And producers and directors and writers like Sam Esmail, who created Mr. Robot, have it on their agenda. They're not being told to do it. They're doing it and setting a trail for other people to do it. And the more people that do that, the more it catches on. And so, and at this time, more than ever, it's absolutely crucial. Because we're talking about a lack of an understanding that's out there that people of color, non-white people, have a certain value as far as being a part of the fiber of this country, as participants, as people who are dreamers, who want something that everyone who ever came here wanted. So for television to take down that responsibility is a huge thing and a really important thing and absolutely vital to help move the needle on these other issues in real life.